Welcome back to Experiential Lit. There's no question that humans have overexploited the environment and continue to deplete natural resources all around. The biggest telltale is perhaps the Aral Sea, formerly the fourth largest lake on the planet. The name roughly translates as Sea of Islands, referring to over 1100 islands that once dotted its waters. Now reduced to be called as one of the planet's worst environmental disasters. It had exceptional array of species with its own native biodiversity, covering an area of 68,000 square kilometers before 1960s. Over time, it has reduced to hold only 10% of its water volume. We can partly blame Stalin for his ambitious economic plan, which caused a snowball effect, leaving the lake's biodiversity collapse, shutting all fishing industries, bringing unemployment and hardship. In this episode, let's take a look at its past glory and what the future holds. Amu Darya and Sir Darya, two rivers that flowed down from the mountains, bringing in rainwater, snow melt which pooled together to form a majestic lake that was named as the Aral Sea. It was spread over seven Central Asian regions and sits between Kazakhstan in the north and Uzbekistan in the south, which brought in life and happiness to over 30 to 60,000 fishermen and its neighborhood. Its biodiversity flourished with many native fish like Eurasian ruff and northern pike. The fate of Aral Sea changed in 1960s. The Soviet Union undertook a major water diversion project and systematically diverted the water for the purpose of agriculture irrigation, using canals to convert desert into cotton farm and other crops. It certainly was a success to get the desert bloom at the cost of the Aral Sea. The Soviet Union was not surprised, or rather anticipated, the Aral Sea's fate. Excessive water diversion from the two rivers caused the sea to dry up. As it could not replenish, it began to shrink. By late 1980s, it was reduced to form into the North Lesser Sea and South Greater Sea. In 1991, Uzbekistan gained independence from the Soviet Union and became the world's largest producer of cotton in 1998. With profit and cotton demand increasing, Aral Sea continued to shrink with its salinity increasing. It was more salty than seawater and Dead Sea combined, and this led to most of its native fish dying. Pesticides and fertilizers were used to increase production and letting contaminated water settle back, causing it to get more polluted with greater health risk. In 2003, the South Greater Sea shrank and was further divided to form eastern and western basins. With increased salinity and polluted sea, most of its flora and fauna had disappeared. With this drastic and immediate decline, the Aral Sea was only 25% of its original size. Kazakhstan, with funding from World Bank, devised a plan to build a dam called Aral as a last effort to recover North Aral Sea. The dam was completed in 2005. It stopped the North Aral water flowing into lower elevated South Aral. In 2006, it was recorded some recovery was seen in the North Aral Sea. With NASA's image, it was noted that in 2014, the Great Aral Sea lost its eastern basin, completely drying up. While we can blame Soviet Union for their economic adventures, the fault also lies on nations in the region, who never really tried to save the Aral Sea from its devastating fate. Present day, the sea will never get its former flora and fauna, leaving the land so barren and salty that nothing will grow. But there seems some hope for the Aral Lake. Kazakhstan has reformed its policies and institutions in its water resources sector. Uzbekistan in 2017 had announced $2.6 billion package to revive the water body. Will we ever see the Aral Sea back to its former glory? It's doubtful. Perhaps only small parts of the lake can be revived. But again, time will tell. Alright folks, that's all for this episode. If you're curious or interested in our other videos, links are in the description. Do say hello. If you like our work, subscribe and like. It keeps us motivated. We are on Patreon. This is Noreen. See you in the next one.